Rock as an action hero is second to none.
Stuff he's doing with action is insane.
Everybody's gonna remember this Kentucky fight. The Rock and all these little warriors, these little pygmies.
Rock's uniquely qualified to do stunts. He knew it would be really cool to see his face flying through the air, so he did it.
Oh, welcome to the jungle, big boy!
I'm expecting Stifler, I'm expecting that guy from Dude, Where's My Car? And I get this guy, and he's like, and he's buffed up.
Oh!
Boy, I'm getting hung upside down. Whip fights.
Nobody's ever seen him do this.
Guns.
He's a new type of action actor.
They put me to the test.
Knuckle sandwich, extra cheese.
And action!
We had like a month and a half of rehearsal, and I mean, the truth is, we would rehearse incredible fight sequences.
Andy Chang was a puppet master behind all that. He's the best fight coordinator in the business. And he told me, listen, I want to utilize your power. Everybody knows how strong you are. If you hit somebody in the mouth, all their teeth are gone. I suppose somebody else had just loosened their teeth. And he said, but what I want to do is nobody knows how graceful you can be, how fast you are, how quick you are. And I said, okay, let's do that. I'm willing to give you my body.
Rock has a hard time with remembering things. It's got a really bad work ethic, you know? So what they've asked me to do is really to take on a larger assignment, which is to teach him some fighting moves. Having the action hero mentality.
The only thing Sean could show me is how those muscle softeners really work that he's taken. For some reason, they work really, really well on him.
He's got no idea. He's the character actor, and I'm the male lead action hero.
You see him over there in the background? He's just laughing, joking, having a good time. I hope you get a shot of that. Eating ice cream.
We're in the training facility, the rehearsal lot. And what this particular stunt is, this scene is a big Kon-Tiki fight between myself and the Yanomami Indians. These guys, they're a lot shorter than me, but they really kick ass. And what they're gonna do is they actually utilize the vines in the tree by jumping 50 feet out of the tree, holding onto the vines, and they're gonna actually swoop down, pick me up, and pick me about 100 to 150 feet up in the air, drop me, and it's almost like a pinball. Pa, 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 pa. I fall all the way down.
It's been really cool, like, actually doing myself with a Rock, because normally doing fight stuff, I tend not to like to do things with bigger guys because they're just so slow and uncoordinated. And I was actually quite pleasantly surprised.
Stop.
Go, hurry up. Yeah, Rock, come down here and kick my ass.
Andy Chang did a wonderful job of taking the Hong Kong-influenced style of fighting and reinventing it.
Action!
So that it doesn't feel like Hong Kong, it feels like Brazil and like the jungle.
Do you know him? Do you? Huh? How about this guy? Are they your friends? Yeah?
The first couple days of the shoot, there's this little fight that Rock's character and my character has.
Sean's entire style of fighting is a multi-zone attack system, where he'll attack you 15 different ways simultaneously. I mean, that was something that came from an old style of fighting that I used to do with my friends.
We got some crazy martial arts in this movie. I might know some tiramisu. It's Australian fighting style.
Someone notch blow a black belt in tiramisu.
Tiramisu?
Oh, yeah, baby.
It's Italian dessert, you asshole.
Oh, really?
And, you know, we were away in Hawaii and nobody was really watching, so we just did it.
I think more than anything, what was effective with the training was being familiar with Rock, getting a chance to kind of work with him and Pete and get to know the stunt guys and, you know, and Andy Chang.
There's a fight scene in the movie that we cut where Sean fights the John Grimes character Harvey, a mud fight. Those two guys went at it as hard as I've ever seen anybody fight in a movie.
And that takes Sean, got his ass kicked.
But Sean is tough and scrappy and, you know, got a lot of grit. And he never complained, and he was bleeding, and he was scratched up, and he was ripped up, and I mean, these two guys were slugging it out in a big pit of mud and, you know, doing full tackles with no pads on rock hard mud, and they were going at it.
Good job.
As far as movie fights go, not to compare movie fights with real fights, because they're not nearly as intense, but a good movie fight, you're feeling it for a week. You're bruised and you're bleeding and you're sore, and Sean did it hard.
You get to be it muddy, and really it's every kid's dream come true. I mean, I don't know what I'm gonna do after this movie. It feels like I got to do everything I wanted to do.
It's 4:30 a.m. Been shooting all day and all night. Everybody else is tired, not me. I'm ready to go. Nah, I'm only playing. It's about 8:30 at night, we're almost done.
Every time we dropped him off a tree, or we smashed him in the head with a rock, or we smashed him in the head with a piece of wood, or we threw him off a cliff, we'd sit there and make sure that the shot was gonna be in the film, you were gonna see his face.
Do you know what he does here after this?
I gotta tell you.
They're shooting at Rock's character in another building. I think he throws his guns, he gets a running start, flies through the air. And he takes his forearm and goes,
takes out one of those pillars, and then he falls down the ground, and all of a sudden the pillars collapse, and the guys collapse down. Sick.
It's not like he was always, oh no, this has to be me. He's got a guy named Tunawai who's an incredible stunt double, who actually broke his leg doing a stunt for him in the film and came back and worked with a broken leg. It's not like his attitude is, I have to do all my own stunts always. It's like, if it's good for the movie and you see it's me, it really makes the audience thoroughly suspend their disbelief because it's really happening.
Oh, ow!
And then I'll do it. If not, let's get Tunawai. Rock really is unique in that a lot of times you hear about actors doing their own stunts and maybe they, I don't know, jump off a cable car in San Francisco that's moving 5 miles an hour. They do a little bit of driving. He truly does things physically that actors just can't do.
See, during rehearsals, my man Eddie was doing it. It was fine. We just needed one guy on the cable rig. But in this case, I had one too many donuts yesterday. That's why I almost hit the ground. Now we need two people holding it.
One, action! Yeah.
The first day it was hell, because like immediately we're like, you're upside down and you're swinging back and forth, all the blood rushes to your head, and Rock and I are up like, I don't know how high. At one point I was like, I gotta get down, I'm gonna throw up on you. He's like, dude, get him down.
I felt great. It was good. I mean, what really helped was the fact that we've been able to do this for the past 3 months in pre-production back in LA, so really made a big difference. Didn't have the mud, but I had Andy Chang always in my ear. Hurry, shoot it.
Oh, it was fun. After what felt like a half hour, I lost all control of my bodily functions. I'm just kidding. And it's just one of those things where Rock got to practice it back in, you know, rehearsal stage, and I did. So, I'm fearless like that. Just kidding, I'm a scaredy cat.
Of course it doesn't hurt. Come on, from the Rock, it feels great.
Rock having that training in wrestling has been, A, been really great for all his stunt stuff, but B, just he's just really fearless. And you really need that, because sometimes you're gonna look really stupid out there. And he really is willing to take those risks of just like, for the role. He's gonna sacrifice his own personal comfort or image for the film.
Monkey.
People have asked me if he's the next Arnold or the next Stallone. I don't think he is. I think he's a man with the potential to be something really unique. He's not anything that I've been able to easily define. And his ability to take risks and to try new things and to want to learn, it always surprised me and made me just want to perform all that much more.
Audiences today, they're sophisticated, they're savvy, they know what editing is. They pay the hard-earned money to see their guy, and then all of a sudden a big stunt comes and you see the back of his head. It's like, come on, you know? So that's the very least that I could do to give back to the audience, just make sure that you know it's me.
You okay, Rock, man?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a cut.
That was hard, dude.
Peter, that is the one.
I wanted to do that for not only for the movie and for everybody else who's working hard on the movie, as well as, more importantly, the audience.